The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
You know what bothers me about the whole tone of the interview and the questioning? Is Matt Lauer is ignoring the $64,000 question, or if you want to use another metaphor, the 800-pound gorilla in the room. And that is, racism can't be that bad in America. If somebody like you, a woman of privilege, raised by two loving parents, decides she wants to be black because it's a better experience for her, who would choose to be part of an aggrieved, oppressed racial group if all these bad things happened to that aggrieved, oppressed racial group? Who would choose that? It must not be that bad. America must not be suffering from pernicious racism. Otherwise, why would somebody renounce her whiteness, which presumably gives her a superior path to success, and embrace blackness? Why? Well, I guess it means that calling America pernicious in its racism is not something that really people feel on the ground. Otherwise, I don't think that Rachel Dolezal would decide to become black. I don't think that Elizabeth Warren would decide to become a Native American, even though she can't prove at all that she's got any Native American ancestry, because it was an advantage. Why did Ward Churchill, the one that talked about 800, 3,000 little Eichmanns after 9/11, the one that taught studies in Colorado, why did he, despite apparently having no Native American ancestry, say that he was? Parted his hair down the middle, wore it long. You know, did a hairdo the way Rachel Dolezal did to reflect what she thought might make her look more black. He did his hair in a way to what made him appear to be more Native American. Now, if it's all that bad for minorities in America, why does somebody like Loretta Sanchez, who ran for office using her married name, Loretta Brixey, then run because she lost that race using her maiden name, Sanchez? Is this thing on? But it's just so bad out there for minorities, says Eric Holder. It's perniciously bad. You got all these people running around trying to get voter ID laws. My goodness, they're trying to suppress the vote. On the one hand, Republican Party is accused of missing it by not expanding outreach to minorities. On the other hand, Republican Party is accused of trying to suppress minority votes. So which is it? Republican Party should expand, should outreach? Or Republican Party is engaging in suppression of votes from the very people that you claim they're trying to outreach to? That's the way to win, right? Mitt Romney says that his biggest mistake was not reaching out to more minority voters. And so the same party that feels that they need to reach out to minority voters is going to suppress the minority vote by pursuing voter ID. Does that make any sense to you? Maybe, just maybe, it's possible that some of the people pursuing voter ID really believe that they want to protect the integrity of the voting process. I know that sounds outrageous, but maybe that's the motive. And maybe that's why the majority of blacks also support voter ID. I'm just pointing stuff out.